Hey everyone, welcome to another Usual Suspect video. This is it, it's episode 8. Episode 8 is where we go from Schwangau to Munich. It's not a massive ride, but there are some really good sights along the way, and we do a little detour and we stop off at Dachau, the concentration camp, pay our respects and go and have a look around this live museum. Quite a moving experience, and I would recommend anybody to go there. It's the second time I've been, it's the first time that Bryski had gone. Would absolutely recommend it. After Dachau, we make our way to Eiting, which is where we're staying for the next 2 days. My friend Ben. Cheers, Ben. Has a hotel over in Eiting, which is an absolute recommendation. Not just because my friend, it's a great Bavarian-run hotel. Beautiful, fabulous food, great rooms, really, really reasonably priced. A really, really beautiful little village, and great stop if you don't want to stay in the centre of Munich, because it's only a short jaunt from sort of Eiting into Munich on the train. So Eiting's right next to Erding, where they make Erdinger, as in Erdinger. I don't know if you can see that. A large pint glass. Right next to there, which is a great place again for a night out if you want to go there. We're going to check into the hotel. We're going to have a couple of days there. Once we've checked in, we're going to three S's, and then we're going to be out on the train and we're going into Munich for some of these. And this is my beer for today, Paulaner Münchner Hell. Classic German beer, has to be in a Stein, it's just got to be in a Stein. It's as good as it gets, it's really, really nice. Paulaner Münchner Hell, it's about just over 5%, I think it is. Lovely, crystal clear, lovely. Ooh, it's like nectar. Anyway, I'm digressing, enjoy episode 8. Prost.
Just leaving Schwangau. Neuschwanstein, just over there. Another glorious day. Great stay at Casa Patrizia. Never got there last night, this lost Brauhaus. Would have been nice. Had a little beer in there last night. Just the one. Off to Munich, but we are going to do a stop at Dachau on the way. We're going to go and see the Dachau concentration camp, which is only about 20 minutes from where we're going in Eiting.
Come on, bad boy. Nothing like breakfast with a view. Don't really get much better. That's bad boy. Look at the strawberries and... Oh man. Coffee all over my hand. Don't get much better. It's like an adventure bike trip. But without adventure bikes.
We're on the 17 heading north out of Schwangau. leaving the castles behind, heading towards Munich, like I mentioned earlier, with that stop off at Dachau. Only a couple of hours riding today, tops, so looking forward to 2 days of when we do go on the bike, it'll only be in a really short time, just having that sort of breather, bit of downtime. Into Munich this afternoon for a few steins. And some Bavarian food, looking forward to that. A little bit of shopping, souvenirs and the like. Just to the left, got Lake Forgensee, just beyond the trees. Maybe get a view of it in a sec. Ah, there you go. We did have a choice just before we left Schwangau of going 2 miles up the road and jumping on the motorway, or taking the 17 north. This is why we took the 17 north. It's just like this for quite a few miles. It will eventually spit us out of the same motorway, but it's just a much better drive than just sitting there on 3 lanes of tarmac. Came this way quite a few years ago with my wife in the dead of winter. We went to Hohenschwangau and Castle Neuschwanstein for a day trip from we were staying in Eiting, and it was just such an amazing day. Glorious clear skies like this, but man, it was cold. It was about -5 when we were at the castle. We went up to ride up to the castle and to a place called Marienbrook, which is this bridge. That was an experience because I've never seen ice like it on the path to get there. So this is day 7 and it has been a knackering week. There have been a lot of hardcore roads. We required a lot of effort to ride. So, taking its toll, pretty knackered at the end of every day. Would like to do a little bit more in the evenings, but nah, I'm just too tired. You know, last night, it's a beer hall in Schwangau, which would be right up my street, but yeah, we had one and that was it. Time to go. Just come off the A96. Gone on to the A99, the ring road round Germany, the big ring road around Germany, around Munich. We'll be on this for about 10 minutes. Another absolutely sweltering day. Just come off the 99 at junction 10, heading towards Dachau. Reasonably quiet the motorway today. It was pretty good going. Made a lot of ground.
Arrived at Dachau.
Right?
You're saying just arrived at Dachau.
Oh!
Felt like I got shot in the chest earlier. Some bug hit me right in the tit.
Just went into Dachau. Came once before, quite a few years ago, I think about 2008, with my mate Ben, who we'll meet later. Who's got a place over in Eiting.
which is where we're staying for the next 2 days. And it stuck in my memory, so I thought, you know, it'd be nice to maybe stick this on as part of the itinerary and visit here as we're going to Iting, and it's nearby. Gates of the camp. Work will set you free. You gave me the outlook was bleak. You didn't want to be coming through those gates. We're going to go through the main building just over there and follow it round. As I've been here before, I know what it's like in there. I'm not going to video in there at all. I'm going to just going to leave it here. It's a hard walk. Just left Dachau. That was that was tough. I would recommend anybody to go and visit, but it's a tough watch. It's a tough thing to see. Just on our way to Iting now, where we're going to go and stay with my mate Ben in his hotel for a couple of nights. Just come off the 92. Erding, Iting, just on the last little approach to a couple of nights without riding, well, apart from tomorrow where we're going into Munich to the House of Flames, which is the big Harley dealership, one of them, in Munich. Looking forward to that. Bit of shopping. This is where we are for the next couple of days. And there he is.
quick shower, quick rest after a little beer, sorted ourselves out, quick change of clothes, and we're off into Munich.
Oh no.
Drinkies.
Strippers.
I know nothing about stripping, that's all, nothing. No, off drinkies and Bavarian food. Not even sure we're on the right platform, where we're going, don't know, it is what it is. But yeah, should be good. Hey, guess where we are?
Really?
Yeah. I used to be...
I'm not going muff diving with you.
One of them underwater fish dudes, yeah. Fucking hell. But, provided a well-needed lining. So what's been your favourite bit?
Strippers. Now, actually doing... I really enjoyed riding. Obviously, you have to enjoy the riding to come and do this. I've actually enjoyed switchbacks.
Have you?
I've overcome a fear of switchbacks.
Yeah.
100% switchbacks. That was an ultimate fear for me.
Never fall into it. Do your own pace.
Yeah.
Do your own pace. Don't race. You don't have to race anybody. You're not in a race with anybody. Do it at your own pace. Do it yourself.
Yeah, I am.
Let's face it, how many switchbacks do you think we've done on this trip?
I've lost count.
Three figures at least.
At least three figures. At least.
I would say close to 200.
Whatever.
Yeah. Close to 200 switchbacks on this trip.
Yeah. It's beautiful. But yeah, I've overcome a fear of switchbacks. 100%. That's been the only fear of driving, doing switchbacks.
It didn't show.
I love riding.
To be honest, dude, you've been an absolute joy to ride with. It just seems to work. There's no fucking about, you know.
Yeah, on it.
You know, we just kind of knew it's almost got this intuitive feeling. Two of us spend that much time riding together. It just seems to be quite intuitive of what we're going to do next.
Yeah.
And there's been no.
You know the good thing about it is we both wanted to do it.
Yeah.
It's not like that bitchy. I want to go there.
Yeah.
Wherever we go, wherever we get lost, okay. It happens.
I put the original itinerary together to put a bit of everything in there.
So
we'd have mental roads, we'd have amazing countryside. Mental roads, yeah. We'd have amazing countryside.
Monumental roads.
We'd have some beer.
Oh yeah.
We'd have some camping.
When in Rome.
Absolutely. When in Munich.
And do you know what though? The camping. Loved it.
Oh, I'll be honest, first night when it was raining, that whole snowgate.
Like bullfrogs.
My God. That first night I was like, no, never doing camping again. And then we did Grossglockner, Heineken Butler and Grossglockner. Quite a mouthful. And that was one of the best night's sleep I've ever had.
Like a baby.
And it was absolutely spectacular. I woke up in the middle of the night, stuck my head out of the tent, I nearly did a cry when I looked at the sky. It was that beautiful. I was like, oh, it does not get any better. And then I was awake at 5:30 because of the Swiss doggers in the car behind us. And didn't care. I was up and it was just gorgeous. And in love with that camping bit, so you know what?
Yeah, like I said, I said to you before the trip, and I've said it to many people, I'm used to like 4 or 5 star hotels. I've not been camping since Boys Brigade. To do camping, to get me in a tent. Jesus.
Although, to be fair, the night we were supposed to camp at Stelvio and we didn't, we ended up in that hotel.
Oh God.
That was pretty
bold.
Yeah, that was pretty monumental actually, yeah. That was a mega hotel. That was worth the campsite we were going to being closed. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I won't tell you under heaven, so I'll shut the
gate. Good lad. It was a wise move. Very wise move. Yeah.
We've got
a journey back. We've got the joys of Nancy. Yes. Do you know what? Constance seems like an age away.
It's first. Second day, wasn't it?
It seems like so long ago. You start riding those mountain roads and you lose track of the time that you've been on the road. And it's just,
from Calais, went to Constance, so we've done Germany, got near the Mong, and we've started doing the tours through the nations. And where are we now? Back in Germany.
Yeah.
Absolutely awesome.
Just that. You see, it seems an age away since we were sat in the pirate pub.
It does, but it's etched in my memory. It'll never go away. It's Germany, never.
Talking about the pirate pub. 2 days' time, back in the pirate pub. Oh, Jace, you should have been here.
Oh,
your bike, on your bike, you'd have loved this. We'd have took the piss out of you because you're going on an adventure bike, but you'd have still loved it.
You don't need an adventure bike to do it at all. Let's get on it.
I kind of get the feeling that I've had an adventure. I don't know, on an adventure bike. That's all I'm saying on the subject. Yeah, if you're new to the channel, shame on you. Should have joined ages ago. And if you're not, you've been here for a while. There's more of this coming. We've already started conversations about the Baltic states, possibly doing another 8 nations, but slightly different routes, maybe taking it to different countries. Do you know what? It's early doors. Probably going to take me a few weeks to process this. This whole video is probably going to be, well, you'll be watching it now, probably be in 6, possibly 7 parts. And then we've got Normandy next year, 80th anniversary of D-Day. That is going to be awesome. Although at the moment we're struggling to find accommodation because D-Day, 80th anniversary celebrations, are bringing in the tourists like you wouldn't believe. And then there's a lot of places hiring flats out for the week for 11 grand. So we're struggling to find accommodation at the moment. Hopefully we will. And if we do, it's going to be awesome. So, thanks so much for tuning in. It's not like I'm signing off and saying goodbye. I've got another 3 days this year, yeah? But thanks for tuning in and watching. This one is for all the new subscribers and the old subscribers. You're all amazing. don't forget, hit that notification bell, like, subscribe, comment, like the comments. Do you know what, even when people are negative, still like the comments. Yeah, a bit of a buzz from the dickheads, the people who've got something unconstructive to say. But that make you chuckle. I like to come back with things like, my apologies, I'm not quite as awesome as you. That works for me. There we go.
Just come out of the Hofbrau house. We're off mooching into Munich. I'm just looking at some of the architecture. Some of the architecture looks absolutely fabulous. I'm really, really enjoying the buildings and that. Yeah. What a great city. Yo. The world at your feet. Everywhere you go, there's something different. Today we've got a hippie banging a wok. Hippie over there banging a wok. The rat house. This is Marienplatz. Be honest, not a massive fan of the hippie banging a wok.
Yeah, that's where we are. Yeah, absolutely. In a place that serves me, 100%.
Oh dear, what timing.
Augustina.
These are getting heavier.
Yeah.
The pod.
For the dunkel. The dunkel this time. Sweet baby Jesus in the office. Yes, we've had a lovely time walking around the shops. The ones mostly between the last beer hall and this one. I'm not saying there's a theme, but I'm enjoying it.
I didn't see much.
I don't care.
What was you looking for in the shops? Because I didn't see much.
Stuff, yeah, stuff.
Trinkets,
yeah.
Souvenirs.
Yeah. All that, everything here.
Yeah. And we stumbled on this place.
It's quite glorious. So, tomorrow, House of Flames, which is Munich Harley. So, writing on a postcard, do I buy a t-shirt or do I go all out and buy a full-on pair of jeans or a nice cut or maybe an open face helmet, which I've never been a fan of, but if I find the right one, I'll go with that.
Or Harley.
Writing on a postcard to P.O. Box, knoboff.com. No, just writing on a postcard, that'd be great.
But I think you need to drop the hammer on the road, King.
No. So, we've been sat here in Augustina for about 45 minutes. And I've had a stein of dunkel, and Brian's had a stein of, well, not dunkel, just
piss.
Beer. And the couple you can see in the background, you name it, if they could have got away with it in public, they've done it. Just wow. In public. And there's families and people coming in and out of this place, and it's been some sort of finger fest.
Is that the fish?
I was walking the chips. Yeah, is that the fish? Now they've got some chips to go with it. Where we are now.
We're at the beer hall in Munich. That's fab. Sweet Jesus. But I'm like, do I go with sausage or do I go with ox? I think I'm going to go with ox. To all the vegetarians and vegans out there, yeah, roast ox, that sounds meaty, meaty-licious. I would love at some point in my life to be able to say that I feel bad about that, but I don't, so ox it is. Ooh, gently cooked in the oven overnight, juicy, flavourful and tender, in a rich red wine sauce with red cabbage, cream potatoes and a Bavarian ox. Nummy, nummy, num. Yeah, I'll be honest, one of the, because I'm a massive beer monster and I love beer, and especially I love German beer, and I love in all its forms. I really fancied eating at the Hacker Beer Hall, and I'm here with a beer, and we've been sat here for a huge amount of time, and we've had nobody come to us for, do you want food? Be chosen from the menu. We've got the menus, got them when we got arrived, but honestly, a little bit disappointed. And the guy serving us looks like Captain Tanaka from The Matrix, a little bit, like a skinny version of him. And I've got to be honest, although he was a bit of a hero, this guy's not, he's a bit of a tit. But it is what it is. Who can say where we go from here? Oh, I know where we go from here. We're going into the station, we're going to find some crap food, we're going to get a train back, and we're going to get shit at a Benz. Maybe. I don't know what Brian was pointing at then, but.
Strippers.
Now, he's mentioned strippers a number of times, and to be fair, in the old days, I probably said, fill your boots, jump in. However, I've been to a strip club in Munich many years ago, and many years ago, it was €50 for a very, very uninspiring 3 minutes. If Brian wants to do that, I will happily take him right outside.
Second week of September or third week of September, like we did it last year.
No? Alright then.
Oh shit.
Let's get one.
Yeah, do it. Oh. Look at the top.
No.
The
blue? No.
Just the blue?
No.
No, give me the blue!
I don't think he gets out much.
You're a bad teacher.
Whatever.
Bad teacher.
Whatever. So. Well, we're at Marienplatz station on the way back to Wording after a most uninspiring tea. Last time I was here, I couldn't speak.
I've got to be honest, I'm shitting. I've got no idea where I am. I've done a whiz, I've kind of wandered off. Music's good. Bothered, bladdered. This is the fucking best place ever.
It's not the same tonight. At the moment. Get back to Ben's, a few more beers, blah, 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 blah. But, yeah. We've been around some beer halls. We've looked at some shops. We're going to come back and purchase some shops tomorrow. But yeah, it's been good. It's good. I'm not blowing bubbles, so it has been good.
Many hours later.
We're on our way into Munich. I mean, we went into Munich yesterday, but we went on the train so we could have a few beers. And we did. And then we had got back and had a few more. But yeah, we're on our way into Munich today. We're going to the House of Flames, which is the which is the Harley Davidson dealership in Munich. There's actually two Houses of Flames, but we're going to the big one on this side of Munich. Maybe do a bit of shopping, maybe do a bit of mooching, all that kind of stuff. Just, yeah. Another short day's riding today. Ben and Connie are hosts at the Gasthaus der Post in Eiting, which is a fab hotel. If you're coming out this way and you don't want to stay in the city centre, a little bit on the outskirts, near to Erding, so you can go and get a pint of Erdinger from the tap room there. It's a great little place to stay, absolutely great. All mod cons, really, really great hospitality there. Food's great, beer's great. The Eitinger beer is absolutely fabulous. Been here a few times, but I've never been this route, so this is a new one for me. Love this part of the world. Fabulous hospitality, really, really lovely people. Great little tiny Bavarian villages. Most have got their own breweries, which is great. Cooler today, but not by much, I've got to be honest. I said, oh, it's going to be about 22, 23 today. It does not feel like that. It feels more than that already. Yeah, it was 32 yesterday. It was harsh. When we were in Munich, just walking around, Jesus, we kept needing to find like liquid refreshment to keep us cool. Won't be doing that during the day today. Might be a different story tonight. And there we have it. Harley Davidson Munich, the House of Flames. Look at this bastard here. I had one like that, hit me in the chest, it felt like I'd been shot. Yeah, bastard. Whoa, look at that. All skizzards there everywhere. Nasty. You dirty bastard. House of Flames. Gonna do some shopping. They're tired and dirty now. Even worse by the time we get home day after tomorrow. Two days after tomorrow. 3 days time. It's fucking lovely. That's absolutely beautiful. I'm just not a fan of the front. Don't like the front end on them, no. Shocking here, to be honest. It looks like they put about 10% on the prices of everything just because we're in Munich. You know, stuff that you'd expect for 500 somewhere, it's 600 in here. It's just bananas. I know it's not 10%, but you know what I mean. But to be fair, this place is like a candy store. It's just mega. How much?
£26.
Yeah, checking the... This is absolutely fabulous. It's like a Harley dealership, but bigger. That's lovely. Oh, it's got the classic Harley oil leak there. Fabulous. That is. That's lovely. That's absolutely beautiful. $49,000. Okay. Want them bar stools. Wow. This is very, very cool. That's beautiful too. Look at that. It comes with a free box of tissues. That's beautiful too. Wow. King. Slightly older one. Bonnet all that. Everybody comes up here to drop the guts.
I'm just going to gently waft it out near you. There you go. Isn't it?
It's a nice bike, but the clothes are ring.
Oh, well, I've seen what I'm buying. Oh, yeah. Cranking it by hand.
Yeah. You see, my old bag, soft tip.
Yeah, barrel. Yeah. Fingers. Okay, take that. Right, I'm going to shop. Well worth the visit. Well worth it. Well, that was the House of Flames, the big one out of the two. Fabulous place, but about 25% dearer than any other Harley dealership I've ever been on everything, bike, clothes, you name it. Tried to buy a Willie G t-shirt, but I was stood at the counter for nearly 20 minutes while some muppet who wanted to hire a bike had forgot his paperwork. So I'll just give it up in the end. We'll stop at Harley Davidson in Reims, and why the hell not? I think we're going to head out, make our way back to, oh, front end of that's gone, make our way back to Iting, yeah. I think we're going to go to the shopping Platz Park thing. You got all the Google Maps, haven't you? Jesus. Well, we were going to go into Munich to do some shopping and that sort of stuff, and we decided we can't be arsed because it'd be finding somewhere to park and all that kind of malarkey and lots of dicking about, and thought, nah, you know what, give it a miss. So there's a big shopping park near, just on the outskirts of Erding. We're going to go there.
Just had a very civilised lunch at the Erdinger Brauhaus in the middle of Erding, which is fab. Just stopped for ice cream. Yeah, I went for the bucket. It looked good. You can blame me. I filmed me eating it, but I can't because obviously it takes two hands. So, good night, Vienna.
Last night, restaurant.
You didn't tell her?
No, I forgot to tell her.
Oh, no way. Day eight. Love the pints of hiding it.
Mmm.
Short day today, but eventful. Yeah, nice lunch, visit to the House of Flames, cold one later on, or cold two or three later on. Yeah. It's been good.
Chilling day,
yeah,
wasn't it?
It's a very chilling day. It was needed after after what we'd done it last week.
Today, 1700 miles?
Yeah. Today was needed. 9:50 left, yeah.
Bring it on.
Luckily we split it into three. Because otherwise 9:50 in one it would just be a lot.
A bit too much, that'd be.
Would be.
But
yeah.
Cheers.
Yeah, cheers indeed. So, all the places that we've stayed, all the hotels and camping and all that sort of stuff, I will add details. You'll see the details flash up during the course of the videos, but at the end of every video, I'll have all the details in for every hotel. Worth bearing in mind, if you're doing a route like this, or you're doing this route, which I would heartily recommend, especially if you've got balls of steel, heartily recommend it. The places we've stayed in are just brilliant, and we've got the whole thing. I think we've done the entire thing, excluding fuel and tolls, for less than 750 quid. So that was tunnel, a couple of nights of camping, rest in hotels, you name it. Yeah, 750 quid tops, probably less than that. So I'll put a toll again right at the end of the video. Once I've added it up properly, I'll stick the toll on, just so you've got an idea of what things cost. But it's well worth doing, absolutely well worth doing. Been game changer ride. It's going home tomorrow. Starting the journey home tomorrow.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah, boo-hoo indeed, yeah. Yeah, it's been a cracker. Just saying to Brian a minute ago, I think the next ride we should go to Kazakhstan. Get it down.
Oh dear.
Yeah, just keep it something sensible for the next one. Kazakhstan or Mongolia. Yeah. Catch on the next part. Well, after a couple of beers, well, okay, a few beers. It's the end of the last day before the journey home. It's a 3-day journey. So we've got tomorrow, the day after, and then we've got the day after that when we hit England and travel back. So it's a 2.5-day journey. Absolutely amazing. Amazing ride. Yeah, really, really good ride. Had some laughs along the way. More than a few beers. It's been kind of sad that I'm going, but I'm also kind of pleased that I'm going, if you know what I mean. Yeah, it's been a riot. Strange enough, it's been an 8 nations road riot. For all them that said that they were gonna come and then didn't, more fool you. Mint. Insane. 1955 Silver Door.
Wow.
Oh well, that's unfortunate. He thinks he was maybe going too fast round bend.
Some sort of piece of meat like that, that Flintstone was carting it away.